a crater at the Nevatim military airfield. This is where Iranian missiles hit. Almost all other missiles could be intercepted. While the army is repairing the damage, will Israel respond? An explosive issue that makes the UN Security Council meet for a special session. Israel's representative makes it clear there will be a reaction. This attack crossed every red line, and Israel reserves the right to retaliate. We are not a frog in boiling water. We are a nation of lions. Union Secretary General Guterres appealed to both countries. The Middle East is on the brink. The people of the region are faced with the real danger of a devastating, all-out conflict. Now is the time to defuse and de-escalate. 2 weeks ago, the Israeli army allegedly attacked the Iranian embassy in Damascus. In the night to Sunday, Iran's counterattack with drones, missiles, and cruise missiles. Chancellor Scholz, for example, sees the fact that Israel was able to fend off almost everyone as an argument against a retaliatory strike.
This is a success that perhaps should not be given away either. Therefore, our advice is to contribute to de-escalation yourself.
The United States, France, and the United Kingdom are also warning of further escalation. But for Israel's war cabinet, the only question is how and when.
There are two positions opposite each other. Some say that a hard, clear answer is needed. But there are also more moderate voices, for example Defense Minister Gallant or the opposition politician Gans, who say that it does not have to be a measure right away.
Yesterday, the war cabinet could not come to an agreement. The decision on how to react has been postponed until this afternoon.